I'm going to be talking about the future of retail and how we're going to buy things in future, and the changing balance between the old-fashioned world, where we either went to the physical store or maybe we looked online and then we bought something online. In future, it's all part of the same thing. Mm-hmm. We go to a physical shop for an experience, to be entertained, to learn something, to touch things, smell, taste, at the same time, we're probably already browsing at the competitors.
It's a competitor store.
In the store. Okay. So it's all about a conversation. It's about a conversation that is face-to-face, a conversation which is virtual, but it's all becoming the same thing.
Okay, so the main theme of the challenge is that tech is transforming retail and also the customer experience. How does it happen? Can you give us an example?
Yes, what we're learning is that customers who are thinking about going shopping are often using two or three different channels. Mm-hmm. So they may start by, the first channel is they talk to a friend.
Okay. Word of mouth.
Planning a holiday. And then in Greece, okay.
Yeah,
the second channel is they're browsing online. The third channel is they meet someone else at a party. Maybe they go into a travel agent. And then the fourth channel is they're on the airline, and the fifth channel, and they're changing from one device to the other, from mobile to
it's an omnichannel.
And they make the final decision on the phone.
Yeah.
And then they phone the call center.
Okay.
So we're talking about customers which are very dynamic in how they interact with brands and how they make decisions. And we know that for the people in the shopping mall here, mm-hmm. Who run shops, we know that people are 83% more likely to come back again if the shop has a relationship with them across more than one channel. So it's not just they come in to buy the shoes, but they are on they are receiving text messages from the shop with a special offer, mm-hmm. or they have a loyalty card, or there's some other relationship that's going on.
And new types of marketing, like proximity marketing, for
yes,
example.
Yes, absolutely. Proximity marketing is a very important part of this. And when we understand how all of these things operate together, then we can create a much better experience for the customer.
Okay. Let me question about this. I Google you, and I see that your title is Futurist Keynote Speaker. And also one of the title of your books is The Future of Almost Everything. So, Patrick, how difficult is to predict the future? Do you have some methods, some tips to share with me?
I do have some methods, and I'll tell you a secret.
Okay, I like secrets.
Okay. You can have all the methods in the world, but the most important thing is to understand a little bit of history. Mm-hmm. You see, you can read the media headlines or even read your magazine, and you get lost in all the noise about the excitement of this and that.
Too much info.
Well, the trouble is it gives a wrong impression, because here's the fact. Mm-hmm. My family have enjoyed going to Corfu for years.
Okay.
We've been going to Corfu on holiday for 30
Corfu,
years.
Yeah.
Now, listen, I don't want to insult you, but Corfu is the same. It's the same experience. Now, listen, it's not because of Greece. You come to London on holiday.
Yeah.
You can say, I've been visiting London on holiday for the last 30 years. And I say, yes, have you noticed any difference? Of course not. The cars still drive. There's still black taxis. And you will spend most of your time in a hotel. You check in the same way you used to check in, mm-hmm. 20 years ago. You eat in restaurants. You go to the cinema. You go to the theater. You go to a nightclub.
The habits are the same.
The habits are the same.
The way of life?
Much the same. You see, the world is changing less than you might imagine. And if you think of someone, maybe they had a terrible accident 20 years ago, they have been unconscious, then they suddenly wake up and they walk around Athens. What are they really going to notice? You know, people will be dressed the same. I'm sorry, I hit the microphone, I'll repeat that. You know, people are even dressed the same. You know, has anything changed in the clothing that you or I are wearing? I will look around the audience this afternoon, mm-hmm. and I will look at the men and the women, and honestly, if I take a photograph, mm-hmm. and I show you a photograph of audiences 5 years ago, 10 years ago, 15, 20, you will not be able to tell which is the photograph from 2019.
So what really changes? We speak about the change generally. The tech revolution.
A lot. Mm-hmm. Okay, but I'm just saying that a lot of things are changing slowly.
Okay.
And even the things which are changing fast are changing in a way which is quite predictable. You know, social media has been here since 1998.
Correct.
You know, I wrote the e-banking strategy for a large Swiss bank in 1997. You know, I was using speech recognition in 1980 for the first time. Okay, it was
1980.
Not... 1980. Okay. It was not interesting. Good, but we knew it would get better. Okay,
yeah.
And it has. Is that such a shock? No. All the world is so changing so fast because we now have speech recognition. Listen.
So we have more tools.
We have more tools now. But okay. These are tools we expected for the last 30 years. Almost all the big trends are ones which I have described in my books for the last 30 years. 30 years.
Impressive. So in this book, do you describe some trends for the next decade?
Absolutely. I'm describing, in fact, I have just updated it with a new chapter describing life in 2100.
2100?
Yes.
Okay, how life is going to be.
Guess what? People will still be eating in restaurants and driving.
I think so.
Well, they will be inside the car, they will be driven by a robot, but they'll still be driving inside a car. They may not own the car, but they will have their own homes, they will fall in love, they will get married, they will look at the weather,
Are you sure about the holidays? Okay. So we have different tools because of the tech, but our habits remain the same.
Yes, I prove it to you.
Okay.
Listen, you know, I had a big debate about this with a Greek waiter in Athens, okay? He said, look behind you, what do you see? I said, I see the Parthenon. He said, yes, of course. And told me, how many currencies have we had? You know, think of the Eurozone. How many currencies, how many empires have we had since the Parthenon? He said, Greek language will continue. Greek culture will continue. And Greek tourism will continue.
And Greek culture is too strong.
And it will still be here in 3,000 years. The Parthenon will be here ready to say hello to them. So I just say we need to have a sense of history, of perspective, and to understand that the way we communicate with each other has changed dramatically because of smartphones.
Mm-hmm.
The way we get information has changed incredibly. But many other things in our daily lives have changed relatively slowly and will continue to change relatively slowly.
So you check what is changing slowly and you advise business leaders, leaders generally?
Yes, because companies usually focus on their own industry, they are experts in it. They make the future.
Mm-hmm.
And they know those trends, and the trends are usually happening relatively slowly. Take this seat. This is a seat in a cinema. Do you really think it will be dramatically different in 25 years' time? No.
I don't know about the seat, but about the...
the films?
The films?
Ah, I'm not so sure. You know, 3D TV,
mm-hmm.
It's great in a cinema. But it is now impossible anywhere in Greece to buy a 3D TV. Do you know why?
Why?
Because it creates wow, but no magic.
But if you are going to use virtual reality, for example, to see a movie, it will be a chance.
Maybe, yes. I think that most movies will still be 2D in 20 years' time.
Speaking about the future, when you were young, do you have imagined such a future for you? Because, as I read, you have spoken to several hundred thousand people in over 60 nations.
My first article I wrote mm-hmm. about the future was when I was 10.
10? Okay. And you have kept it?
I have.
Okay.
It described the future of the railways. And it described the loss of huge numbers of railway tracks. But I was wrong about one thing.
What?
When I was 10.
What?
I didn't realize that railway would come back.
Mm-hmm.
That rail would become incredibly popular. So that all the trains in Europe are full.
Okay. But you are a business guy. You are a serial entrepreneur. Except from the books, you have founded many companies. Today we have a challenge for startups who bring new technologies. are there really some tips for them to succeed? Because,
yes.
you know, it's very hard to succeed when you are, you are a startup, not only in Greece, but globally.
The trouble with startups is you usually start with a great idea, and then they look for customers. They say, look at this amazing idea. It's going to change everyone. They need to start the other way around. Start with the customer and say, now, tell me, what is wrong with your life? What is your biggest frustration? How can I help you? And then produce something amazing for them. Mm-hmm. They will create magic.
Okay.
So innovation does not create magic. That was what was wrong with 3D TV. That is why you cannot buy a 3D TV anywhere in Greece. All the companies kaput, finished. Why? Because 3D was a great example of a startup innovation, very clever. So smart, 3D TV. But nobody wanted to buy it.
So innovation is not enough to succeed.
Innovation is nothing.
It's nothing. Okay. That's a nice approach.
Compared to... Understand your customer.
Have a customer for starters.
Understand your human being, the human being that you wish to serve, okay? And then innovate to meet their need. And when you do that, and you keep looking them in the eye, and smiling as you do it, then you make a lot of money.
So you should understand your customer, that's one tip.
Yes, it's the main one, and the other one, don't run out of cash.
Okay, two tips.
Most of the best innovations in the world, they finish because they run out of money.
This is the two things you check when you are going to invest in a startup company, for example.
Yes, they need to be careful about their finances. They need to be very careful to balance the books, to make their accounts okay, and also keep looking the customer in the eye and smiling.
Okay. This is going to work in the future too. Okay.
It will work in 4,000 years' time.
4,000
years. Those two rules.
So, Patrick, speaking of life generally, what about life outside work? You travel a lot.
Yes, for me it's sailing. It's one big thing. I like being here in Greece, because you have so many islands and it's such an amazing country.
So it's not your first time here, for sure.
Okay. Hundreds of times.
Okay. So, to close this discussion, do you have a message for the future of Greece?
Message for the future of Greece, yes. Keep looking at the Parthenon and understand this, that when the world is going crazy all around you, Greece will still be here in 3,000 years.
Very interesting. So, Patrick, it was nice to meet you.
Thank you.